All new tonight here at 10. Right now, the Senate is working to get together on a bipartisan gun bill.
And just a few hours ago, a group of senators released the specifics on the bill that they've been negotiating now for almost 2 weeks. Matt Morrow joining us now with the very latest on that. Matt.
Erica, Jeremy, if this bill passes, it'll be nothing short of monumental. Congress has not passed any significant gun laws since the 90s, but the Senate thinks it has a breakthrough with this new 80-page bill. In fact, it just took a test vote in the last few hours. It passed 64 to 34. I'll break down the three major new laws that are in this bill right now. First, background checks are going to expand for people who are buying guns and under 21. Authorities will have up to 10 business days to review buyers' juvenile and mental health records. Plus, the so-called boyfriend loophole will be eliminated. This means serious dating partners will be included in a federal law that blocks domestic abusers from being able to buy guns legally. Right now, the law includes abusers who are married and live with their partners. Now it's going to expand. And states will now be able to use federal money to create and implement red flag laws like the one we have here in Colorado.
I want to make sure we actually do something useful, something that is capable of becoming a law, something that will have the potential to save lives.
I believe that this week we will pass legislation that will become the most significant piece of anti-gun violence legislation Congress will have passed in 30 years. This is a breakthrough.
Besides all that, the bill also provides millions of dollars for expanding mental health resources, both in communities and in schools. Plus, there is a lot of money that will go directly to school safety. The Senate's going to debate the bill this week. It hopes to vote on it and hopefully pass it before the 4th of July holiday recess. We'll keep you posted. Jeremy.